This is a product empties video where I talk about all of the products that I've already finished, and I'm also going to talk about whether they suited me and if I'd buy them again. If that sounds like something that interests you, then keep watching. Before I start this video, I just want to say that hair care is super subjective. I have 2B, 2C and some 3A hair pieces. I have medium density, high porosity hair. And it's very possible that there could be a product that I absolutely love that does not work for you. Similarly, it could also be the case that something that does not work for me works for you really well. And so if you disagree with any of the points that I'm making or agree, it would be really helpful if you left your hair type, your porosity and your density down below, along with your thoughts on each product that I'm going to be talking about, if you feel like sharing, so that the rest of the community can also benefit from your inputs and we can share our thoughts. Another thing that I want to say is that I've never come across a product that is bad. I wouldn't go as far as to call a product good or a product bad. I don't believe in absolutes like that. So with that being said, let's start with the first product. This is the Plum Hair Mask. As you can see, I've completely emptied it out. Am I gonna rebuy this? No, because my hair needs so much more moisture. I feel like the mask was a little light for my hair. However, I am really, really, really gonna miss this mask because the slip that this mask used to give me, this is one of the best products that I have detangled my hair with. When I say slip, I'm not meaning slip in the traditional sense. Essentially, when we talk about slip, right, we talk about thick, heavy, creamy formulations, right, that make detangling much easier. This is not thick, it's not creamy, but every time this touched my hair, it made my hair soft like butter. And taking a comb and then detangling your hair when your hair is soft. Let me try to explain this a little better. What do we understand by the word slip? So when we're talking about slip, we're talking about thick, heavy conditioners that are super heavy and super thick and super creamy that would make detangling easy. This is not that. This is not what you would imagine when you think of slip. This was a light formulation. It wasn't super creamy. However, the moment this touched my hair becomes soft. And then taking the comb through my hair becomes so easy. It is very unique about this formulation. And that is something that I really fell in love with. When it comes to this mask, it made detangling so easy for me that I'm really going to miss this product. However, when it comes to moisturization and stuff, it's not enough for my hair. But if you don't need as much moisturization as I do, then I would say that this mask is amazing. High porosity girls who have tighter curl types could possibly give this a miss. Alright, so another point that I have to make, fragrance. Now, I've been on this channel constantly talking about fragrances bothering me and triggering my migraines. And even though that is true, there are certain fragrances that I'm able to get away with that are light, super light and non-triggering to my migraines. And when that happens, I really enjoy them. This is such a product. This has a fragrance, but it never bothered me. And it just added to my experience of like luxury and fabulousness. And so if you could take this fragrance, then I would say that you'd really like this product. The next product that I have completely emptied out is the Arata Hair Gel. And I do have a detailed review about this product, so I'll link that up here and also down in the description. This is such a beautiful hair gel. It is CG friendly, it is cruelty free, it is made in India. And it gives you super soft hold. If you use enough of it, then you'll get a brilliant cast. And if you style your hair to perfection, if your styling routine is on point, and you have that locked and loaded, then you will have virtually no frizz. Even though this is a soft hold gel, if you use enough of it, you will get an incredible cast. And so this is something that I will definitely pick up again, especially when I'm cocktailing gels and stuff, right? This gel is an absolute winner in my books. And if you're okay with soft hold and you're looking for a CG friendly gel, then this is something that I would absolutely recommend to you. But the key thing for you to remember is if you want a hard cast, if you want a cast, then you have to use enough of this. You can't use just a tiny bit and expect like a hard cast if you use enough. And your hair is not super wet when you're styling, then it's very possible for you to get an incredibly hard cast using this gel. The next product that I want to talk about is the Kumuda Conditioner by Just Herbs. And this is a protein conditioner. Now this is a conditioner that I absolutely love and I have raved about this continually. Let me explain why. If you have enough water in your hair, so if your hair is soaking wet and you use enough of this conditioner, then detangling becomes so easy because it just makes the hair super soft and it gives the hair a unique quality that makes detangling so easy. So if I'm talking about slip in the traditional sense, no, this is not a thick, heavy conditioner that is super heavy and super emollient and super thick. And it's not that it's going to give you slip in that sense. However, with this mask and with this conditioner, it's exactly the same feeling. I feel like it makes my hair so soft that running the comb through my hair, even if I have the worst tangles and my hair is like a complete mess on wash day, I just feel like when I use this and when I use this mask, it's exactly the same thing. The formulation is super light, but the moment you use enough of it, it makes the hair so soft that the comb glides through the hair and it is so beautiful. That experience of detangling is so amazing. Another product that I find works exactly the same way is the Plum Conditioner. That conditioner is also one of my favorites. Coming back to this conditioner, I absolutely love it, and this is something that I will use again and again and again. This is a product that is not leaving my arsenal. On its own, this conditioner is quite expensive, so I would say that wait for the 1:1 sales, and the moment that happens, that is when you pick this up. Never pay full price for this if you can get it for half off. The next product is the Umberto Giannini Curl Whip Curl Activating Mousse, and this is an incredible mousse. But the problem is, this is not CG friendly, this has dimethicone. However, this is the first mousse that I used on my curly hair journey and I absolutely fell in love. Now, since this is not CG friendly, I wouldn't pick this up again. This has dimethicone in it, but this worked so well on my hair that I'm really gonna miss this. I wish the brand came out with a CG friendly option because this formulation is absolutely incredible. It worked so well for my hair, however, not CG friendly. And so since this is not CG friendly, I would not pick this up again. But was I happy using this product? Yes. If you're not following the Curly Girl method to a T and you don't mind silicones, then I would say that this mousse is incredible. I would vouch for this. However, if you're following CG, then this won't be for you. As for me, I can't pick this up because right now I'm not really using silicones. So that is that. Alright, so let's talk about a mousse that is CG friendly. This is the Enliven Mousse, and the deal is that, look, the hold is not incredible. Is it as incredible as this mousse that I used? No. But it's CG friendly, it's very inexpensive. I paid 299 rupees for this. I would buy this again because it's CG friendly, it's cruelty free, it's available in India, and it comes at a budget. So even though this is not the best mousse I've ever used in my life, I would buy it again because it fits my need. The next product is the Umberto Giannini Curl Scrunching Jelly. And although this is not CG friendly, it does have methyl paraben. However, this is such a stronghold gel that I'm absolutely in love with this. I have been holding on to the last bits of the gel. So I just have this much of the gel left. This is something that I've been holding on to and I've been hoarding it and not wanting to finish the rest. So I'll consider this to be an empty. And if I'm ever in a boots again, this is something that I would absolutely pick up. So on my curly hair journey, this is the gel that I first used. I think this is the first gel that I ever used. And I fell in love with a hard hold. Now this is the product that ruined every single CG friendly gel for me, because once I got used to and got addicted to this kind of hold, nothing has come close. Especially if you have wavy hair, you know that hard hold is like the key to having beautiful results. And so yeah, this gel, I would go back to it. I absolutely recommend this if you're in the UK or if you're in Dubai, or if you have a Boots next to you, or if you could order from Look Fantastic, then it is available there. You'll pay 675 rupees for this gel. Absolutely recommend. I love this gel. All right, so the very last product that I want to talk about is the Enliven gel in green. And the deal is that in our household, we go through gels really quickly because my husband uses gel every single day. And so I'm hardly able to hold on to one gel for like more than a month. Maybe not a month, but I guess between me and my husband, we go through one tub of gel in like 2 months, especially since he uses gel every single day. So even though this is not empty, I'm going to include this in the video because I got a question the other day in the comment section. And so I want to talk about if I would buy this again. Now the deal is that this is my second tub of the green gel, and given a choice, I would go back to the blue Enliven gel, even though that's a level 4. This is a level 5 hold, and you guys know that my hair loves hard hold gels. However, I feel like I enjoyed the blue gel a little more. If I had to pick this up again, I would go for the blue one because I feel like that is a little less drying on my hair compared to the green. And so if you're looking for my recommendation, I would pick the blue gel over the green any day. With that, I'm gonna end this video. And if you're interested in hair care, feel free to check out these videos.